Ah, the decaying crypt with living bones, living corpses, and living spirits. Basically, this crypt be bumping and the only thing not shaking are the chunks of rubble on the floor. But before I tell you where this goes, you should probably know how we got here. I wanted to delve another crypt, continuing to dog my character's mission. Town went fine, looting some gold during a blackout, but the journey here, not so much. I tangled with some vibin' vermlings who did an exceptionally brutal 2 damage and poison to both my characters, which adds to the scenario effect of stacking 3 curses in Diego's deck. I almost wish I hadn't read the bottom of the road card revealing I could have had experience rather than this brutal punishment, but there are no takesy-backsies in the cold hard world of Gloomhaven. So back to our crypt. Basically, this was a giant shit show. I started the room brooding as a brute do, getting up close and personal. There's nowhere to hide, so yeah, I thought it'd work out. At first, it seemed promising, and I even burn a trample in my boots bonus movement to try and hit 3 guys at once while clearing away. But it flips 2 of my curses, and a few ridiculously powerful attacks later, and Diggs is about toast. I full-on armor up and get a few nice retaliates in as I consolidate to a corner. We clear out a few, then both of us run to opposite corners out of harm, then come back with our own ranged attacks to slay the beasts. But doing so took so much out of us, and our full rest only clear our poison, which by the way was super painful to start with, both for the added damage but also to stop our healing, and it's looking super grim. We decide to take on the next hallway with Nan going invisible and trying for the surprise attack. I still have a brief bit of invulnerability from Juggernaut, so Diego goes right in, but the living corpses, particularly the elites, suck up so much damage that not even swinging for a doubled invisibility visible 6 attack combo takes it down, and we are suffering. The living spirits round the corner and pelt us with ranged attacks, forcing poor Diego to ditch a card over 1 measly damage, and even priming some wind to get a full-powered skewer results in just barely offing the elite. Oh, and of course, the spirits are now adding 2 curse cards to each of our decks. With only a few cards and even less health left on each character, I decide to make a final hurrah. Look, I'm a realist. I know when I'm beaten, but I am also smart. I can make use of the time I have. Nan goes fast, making her the ideal target, stepping back and popping some throwing knives for a little experience and killing off 1 spirit, while Diego uses jump and his boots to zoom around the corner, getting right up close to the door. Nan gets flattened as expected, but Diggs ditches a card to avoid the last damage, then uses his last cards to burst out 6 movement, nabbing some experience and rushing to the chest, then exhausted, falls to the floor. While I may have suffered my first loss, the experience and loot take out the sting and make it so I don't have to factor in the chest during my next go, but will that be enough? We'll soon find out on the next episode of In Gloomhaven. MVPs, sweet high tops for an epic 10-meter dash.